you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please rise as our host, Honorable Minister Thokozitiza, enters. Oh, she has already entered. You are most welcome. Thank you so much. Hello, hello. Please be seated, dear guests. Thank you.
Women's Recognition Award, proudly brought to you by the Department of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development. Under the theme, Women's Socioeconomic Rights and Empowerment, Building Back Better for Women's Resilience. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2022 Women's Recognition Awards, proudly brought to you by the Department of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development. Under the theme, Women's Socioeconomic Rights and Empowerment, Building Back Better for Women's Resilience.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues, please give it up for the bubble lady. Have you ever seen anything like this? That was amazing. Thank you so much. We'll be seeing more of her a little bit later. My name is Lebo Mashila. I have been entrusted with the wonderful responsibility of being your program director for the 2022 Ministers Women Recognition Awards, previously known as the Female Entrepreneur Departmental Awards. Of course, we know that the last 2 years have been utter mayhem because of COVID. We are also still dealing with the fallout of that. The women that we are recognizing tonight are women who formed part of what we call essential service providers. These are the women who kept the nation fed. These are the women who woke up every day while many of us were locked in the house due to COVID. They went and made sure that we had food on our tables and that we were able to sustain ourselves. So we recognize them tonight. And if for the first time in 2 years, we are back again convening, I have the great pleasure of celebrating with you the contributions of these ladies. And I know that they've traveled far and wide to be with us from all over the country. We're recognizing smallholder farmers, we're recognizing commercial farmers, we're recognizing agro processors, and we're grateful, ladies, for all of the efforts that you have made for the past 2 years and in the many years that led up to your recognition. Can we please give them a round of applause? And now please join me in the singing of our national anthem. I know that you have all had the opportunity to spend the day together. Oh, please excuse me. Kitabolwa ke di allergy, sinuses. We should be praying for rain, actually. Lona batho who know how to deal with the earth. We should be praying for rain right now to help us. I just wanted to make the point that because we have spent the day together, we know the people who are in the room. There are many dignitaries in the room. So we can take it that all protocols are observed at this stage. And I want to thank you once again for joining us. Our first speaker who will be giving us our welcome address is Councillor Fanyana Nkosi, who is MMC of Finance and Economic Development for Ekurhuleni. Can we please give him a warm welcome as he makes his way to the stage?
Thank you, Program Director, Minister Me Choko Titiza, Minister Me Ndabeni Abrahams, MPs around here or available here, MECs, member of the provincial legislature of all provinces, councillors, representative of all stakeholders, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, in Bogoto that are here, that we are here because of them. Good evening. It gives me a great pleasure once again to welcome you to the city of Ekurhuleni, the city of peace and opportunity. And Titiza, I thank you for choosing Ekurhuleni as the inaugural place for this great event, and it was a great event indeed. Tonight you are here for a special occasion to honor and appreciate women in the agricultural space for their hard work and dedication. The agricultural environment is challenging by its nature, as we have heard in our engagement in the symposium. Due to the challenging weather patterns and climate change, one needs to perseverance in order to succeed in agriculture. Perseverance. The COVID-19 pandemic has worsened the situation. As a country, we have witnessed a number of farmers declining due to challenges brought by the pandemic. We have had statistics of a number of farmers reducing over the years, but with the pandemic, it has worsened. The women we are honoring today have persevered through tough times. We have proven that with dedication, passion, and hard work, it's possible to make it in agriculture despite the challenges. Mbogoto has alluded to the fact that if you bambi cleaner, you will succeed. We therefore need to find ways to address the many challenges hindering women from pursuing a career or business in the agricultural sector. We need to encourage young people to consider agriculture and agro-processing as a career path. To women we are honoring today, congratulations on your success. I want to challenge you to mentor young people in your community and impart them with the knowledge and skills they need to succeed in agriculture and agro-processing. Like I said this morning, let us make agriculture a culture. Currently, the city of Ekurhuleni, through the rapid land release program, has availed agricultural land to address the issues of access to land. The city will continue through its land release program to provide land to prospective farmers in the phase approach. The phase approach will result in more land being allocated to beneficiaries, especially women, young people, and girls. Many of our youth are unemployed. Let's find a way to stimulate their interest in agriculture. Ngiyabonga. Viva Imbogoto.
Thank you very much, Councillor Nkosi. At this point, I would like to call upon the Deputy Director General of Provincial Operations, Ms. Busisiwe Letompa, to outline the purpose of the recognition awards. Program Director, Ministers, Deputy Ministers, MEC Presidents, DGs and HODs, Farmer Organization, Female Farmer Nominated for Recognition, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, good evening. This recognition award, Gala Dinner, is a culmination of the symposium that the minister hosted during the day. Earlier this year, the minister launched the Agro Processing Master Plan, a sectoral growth strategy that sets out a series of immediate and medium-term actions. One of the key pillars of the AAMP entails provision of comprehensive farmer support, research and development. As such, today's symposium was one attempt to share information with women farmers in four critical areas. The first area, opportunities available for women in communal land, market access, available funding opportunities, and business development. Women empowerment forms an integral part of the AAMP and is seen as a catalyst that will enable the sector to reach the aspiration of the National Development Plan, Vision 2030. The process of identifying the women that will be honored today started in July 2020. The department, DALRAD, a nomination criteria focused on three categories. Namely, the first category was smallholder, commercial, and agro-processing. The developed criteria were consulted with all provincial departments of agriculture and gender-focal persons in DALRAD, provincial shared service centers. Provincial Department of Agriculture were then requested to nominate three farmers who are doing well in each of the three categories outlined: smallholders, commercial, and agro-processing. DALRAD received a total of 27 nominees from 9 provinces. The spread of the nominees that will be recognized tonight is as follows. 10 were smallholder farmers, 8 commercial, and 9 agro-processors. We need to emphasize that these awards are a token of recognition to the farmers, not a completion. We want to convey our congratulations to the women that will be recognized tonight. I thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Letumpa. So just to echo what she was saying, previously, the awards would acknowledge women from each province, would select different winners from the provinces, different winners from each subcategory, and then an overall winner, and money would be given, and. But because we haven't had the awards for the past 2 years, we are recognizing women who have made a substantial, significant contribution in the field of agriculture. Are we feeling grounded right now? Are we feeling good? Are we feeling settled in the room? The function kadile, ne? We are going. Okay, so let's put some food in your belly and let's bring back the bubble lady. I invite you to enjoy the entertainment and also to enjoy your starter. We'll resume with the formal program again shortly. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues, if you haven't noticed, the starters are already on the table. So please feel free to serve yourselves, share, chat while we eat something small before we resume the formal program again. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for the bubble lady. It's a party tonight. We've still got more beautiful entertainment in store for you. But first, I would like to invite Ms. Ntutu Mutsegwa from the African Farmers Association of South Africa, AFASA, to deliver a message of support this evening. Can we give her a round of applause as she makes her way to the stage?
Allow me to write on the protocol that has been reserved already, greeting our Honourable Minister, the Deputy Minister, all protocol observed. You know, I always say I'm a farmer, so it's very difficult now when I'm amongst fancy people and good-looking people. I feel I'm a human being too. Good evening, everyone. My name is Ntutu Mbiko Mutsegwa. I always emphasize Ke Mbiko, program director, because that's the surname of my father. You can leave the Mutsegwa, but you can't leave Mbiko. So mine is to really provide words of support and literally an appreciation from you, Honorable Minister. It is the first time that we have, I was calling it a prosperandi. You know, the commercial sector will have their prosperandi and plan properly. So I'm in appreciation of this kind of prosperandi where you have involved women and people with influence and people with authority and look at a true interpretation of development for women. And obviously, because it is aligned with the master plan, it happened also to be aligned with the continental framework, which is a CADAP. It is also aligned with the UN SDG goals. So if you look at the master plan, we have an opportunity literally to cascade it down to women transformation programs. That framework is enabling us to make sure that we deliver the transformation agenda for women. So from AFASA, Women's Desk, Honorable Minister, we do appreciate. I know during COVID as well, we were part of your team that were crafting the COVID support interventions. We were part of your team that also crafted the agricultural master plan. So we really feel appreciated and valued as the farmers' organizations, particularly the Women's Desk of AFASA, which is the African Farmers Association of South Africa. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Mbiko Mutsegwa. I understand the importance of names. I get it, and I appreciate the correction. Now I'd like to invite to the stage Ms. Pinky Hlabedi from Women in Agriculture and Rural Development, Gauteng, to deliver her message of support. Can we give her a round of applause, please?
Thank you, Program Director. You look beautiful, all of you. But I think I'm the most beautiful woman here. I would like to thank the Minister. Mother, I'm the only one who's calling you Mother tonight. We thank you, Mam Kapa, your Deputy Minister Squasha in absentia. all MECs that are here and the ministers, all senior managers, organizers, we love you as women. It's been long, long not having such events. And what we heard earlier on, Minister, can please, not quarterly, even if it's monthly as a startup, we will go and source money as organizers, as organizations. We invite you. I think all the speakers during the day, they gave us oomph, they gave us power, that we should regroup and rearrange ourselves as farmers. By the way, I'm the farmer in Sidibeng. I've got a very important name here. I'm the queen of Bonsmara. I started farming 2006, planting in the school grounds with all the Wara Wara education level I had. But I quitted working in government and joined agriculture. When we launched WARD, by the way, all the women that are in this house, are you not women in agriculture and rural development? Can you raise your hands and let me see? Or maybe I'm the only one here. All these federations and organizations, they follow women, agriculture, and rural development. By saying so, I'm trying to strengthen it up that women, let's go out and reorganize UWAD. UWAD, it's a brand of women. There's money out there. You heard what Minister said earlier on, Minister Stella. You heard what DTI said. There's money that Pinky cannot access alone, but there's money that we can get as cooperatives working together as organized farmers. I'm standing here being proud as a queen of Bonsmara. White farmers are queuing at my farm. I might not be visited by any official, but spiritually they are there because they know that I'm representing our country positively. They fight with me with prices, but when we go to auction, I am the bull. You know the female bull. I'm the female bull. I always fight for our own farmers in the auctions. I'm saying this to you tonight. We look beautiful. We go back to our farms. Let's go back and rearrange, talk to each other, hold our hands together. Let's access all these markets. Mom said it earlier on. We are not sleeping with Anna. 12 o'clock, we are on WhatsApp, talking about markets, checking what's happening outside. People might think me and Anna, we are friends. We are not friends. We fight because of business. We want to see you growing like us. I was never helped by the department to grow, but when the department in Tolendleleni Senkhulile joined me, today I'm talking to you. Should I say it, ma'am? I'll be getting a feedlot soon in my farm. Not because I've made noise to the department, because they saw a capacity. I might be holding this stick is just to pretend. When I'm putting my boots and overall, you will always ask me, ukhona umlungu wala? Then I will say, no, sikashiwe sizomtshela umlungu ubani wena. So do that so that tomorrow department can see that you are delivering. Then they come and knock at your door. Don't think they are not delivering. We've got women through UWAD who achieved the cold trucks. I'm an 8-ton. We've got women who achieved tractors. We've got women who are queens of maize. I'm planting 200 hectares in my farm. Oh, Mom Anna, they also plant in big lands, purely because of the trainings we acquired. I'm just bragging because I want UWAD to come back and be independent, by inviting uhulumeni, not us being invited by uhulumeni, to prove it to them that all the education you gave us, all the trainings, my file, Mina Minister, is about 68 pages of certificates. And when I take it there, I might be the professor I told you last time. So I don't want to say much. I'm happy with such event. Iyasikhuthaza, and women all over the provinces are reorganizing themselves. Eastern Cape has launched what Gauteng has launched. Northwest, the MEC spoke to me, HOD, they will be launching soon. I'm busy pushing the Free State. I want to see all the provinces launch. Then we can prepare for national. Then we can prepare for 2024. We don't want to lose these farms. You know what I'm talking about. Let's fight for 2024. Let it be our own marathon of assisting uhulumeni. I know you might be having mixed motions here, but I'm not in politics. But I'm saying, Malibongwe! Ikama la makhosikazi! Ndiyabulela.
Thank you so much, Mehlabedi. I'm so moved by what you said, and also by seeing you. You are beautiful and powerful, adorable, actually. And it's, you know, it hearing you speak makes me fully aware of the fact that the soil has always been in the hands of African women. It's just finally African women are getting credit for it. And finally, African women are able to own this soil and develop it and be the ones who are leading this sector, which is so exciting. I feel really privileged to be in the same room as you who are pioneering this. It's wonderful. And now brings me to the moment where I would like to invite the Deputy Minister of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development, Ms. Nokuzola Kapa, who will come and give us a message and also introduce the Honorable Minister. Please, can we welcome her to the stage?
Thank you very much, Program Director. Can I actually acknowledge all our guests today, but the VIPs, the women that have been invited, Sithi Maqobokazana, Angalale Mzini, Kwifithokazi. That's why you are here. I've come to do Dizoniking us. But I made it a point that I was targeting that stage which I can no longer see because immediately I was about to enter, they took it. You know, despite my age, I wanted to compete with this lady, whether it's about being beauty or it's about singing, I will try my best. Thanks God they moved. She also went away. Before I was called upon the stage, I am here indeed to support. I belong to this family. Our family has got three names. I'm not sure of the surname. It is Department of Agriculture, Land Reform, and Rural Development. When you look in table number one, because I'm about to introduce umuntu apa, it's not easy bakuthi ungumuntu. Sometimes bakhona into ekuthiwa yintoni eyihamba pha. So kumhlambi ke kuthiwe ngubani owahamba phaya. But this time ndizoza nomntu. Le tafile le is full of power. That is why bendihleli phaya. You know, the origin yam ndingumntu wasebukhosini. So I always prefer to be either in power or near the power. Today, you will make your own decision whether I was actually having power or next to power. But those women are indeed very powerful, thanks to their organizations that gave us such a leadership. Because we are actually nothing about our provinces because we are national. I don't know any communities that stay at this level. We don't have communities here. That's why we don't go about looking for vote at national. Secondly, I don't know anyone from the province, but these people we're talking about are from villages of our country. Now, they are here today to actually claim the stage. Nyabona ke bantu basemakhaya, rural women in particular, rural youth. You must never be ashamed, even in other countries, to say, I was born behind the door, and my mother was not supported by any medical assistance. But here my head is, just like all heads. Whether there was the oxygen suction, there was none of that. I'm here now. I'm sure my mother would be very proud. Uguti, yes, there was no pram there. It was my mother's back. Also, she was carrying either wood, bucket of water, or thatching grass, mna at the back. Can you see? But really, really, women are great. We can actually ensure, Minister, as you have this gathering, we are telling everybody that lento siyenzayo siyayazi. Yes, lento siyenzayo siyayazi asina value as a result. Because abanye abantu abayazi, thina siyayazi lento siyenzayo. That is why you are here. Naba bantu bethu bathi bayazi lento siyenzayo. Bathi babeke bayenza futhi basazoqhubeka nokuyenza. It is why we continue to grow as this department. All transformations will come and will continue to master that one. I would really assure everybody not to have any fear. This particular ship is stable in this sea. Our ship is stable. We are guaranteed of winning as long as our rural communities are with us. I love them because they stick to one issue. They have common goals. They have common norms and values that guide their own lives. It is important, actually, to say, we go around, someone would come here and say, we are a community of women. We are not just a community like ants. No, no. We are communities because we have stayed together for decades. That's how you would define a community. That community, you must know your neighbor by name and by voice, even if you don't see them. Two, you must have stayed together in that vicinity for decades. But the character is that you share common goals. You have your own unwritten laws that you obey, whereas no one is going to take you to court for non-obeyance. However, it's in your heart that I do as my neighbors do. So we are neighbors, the whole South Africa. Rural women, it's time to come together. It's time to put our differences aside and ensure that we create this one. This time should be about women. I'm told there's women empowerment, there's women, yes. You know, women never wanted to go and look for a job. Did your mother do that? No. Each time you come from school, there will be someone. The smoke, warmth, mother welcoming you, asking you how the school day has been, give you food. Go to bed, warm. Being pet, late game, late. You come, you come back, you say, the door is locked. Hey, mommy is in town. Where's the food? Look there if there's anything in your fridge. You wait and wait, mommy, in the meeting. And sometimes evening in the Galatina. But this is not a, it's not a bad thing to be here. And now there's even that issue that says, today, this time is my chance to go out. Father, stay home. Cook for them. Then when I come back, you can now go. We are in such a situation. But we are very sure. All the other experiences, please, guys, don't throw those lessons away. They will actually ensure our total overthrow of all the oppressions that affect women. It's only when we know where we come from, where we are going, and we actually will be assured of where we're going because we know where we're coming from. Ndifuna ke ukubiza apha, the head of my family. My family, three names. Agriculture, land reform, rural development. If you ever went to a party, yasemakhaya, there are no plates there. You just get a piece of aloe and you put it there and another there, and each one of you, you will have your own kingdom in that aloe. With your meat and your other little things. So, the big ones, family ones, come around a size of this nature, they sit around and eat. But when, because you don't belong, ubanentwana, so the next table, some say, kalapa. No squash, unestable, sake, say, kal. But as his tables, yakilana, sometimes. Ubonba uke wakana kwe sisika minister. But it becomes worse xa ukwena naye ngoku enesithebanyana sakhe. And sathethe uDJ avele yena benesisondela kwe sisika minister. Ubonba, hey, something is not right. Kule family. That's the family we share, but it's characterized by that motherhood. And the motherhood has been confirmed. I'm not, and then said, but Andy Tembe, a man named Tuman, I say India. Because Uba Utema and the Indonesia, the end it, oh, who's on the Tuma, Pigan and Go Kuba, Sandy Kribile, Upper Sandy Kangela, Ube Ben Watchisos, Kuya, India, and Go. So Kufushane, I'll say Indonesia. Nabond Bakalek, why you minister believes that about Tumemna? Nani, you must believe in me, Ngoku. I'm trying to really find a space. So, u minister, Umdong Mama, Sister Langjenge family, Usine family, Amakoskas, the priority, Yake, Leoba, Amakoskas, Onke, but Awe Lali in particular. Konke ke kuthiwe makuyo esikolweni abadala nabancinci balibala kudala ukuya esikolweni kwathathwe bahlanjwe kuthiwe basuka kwinarisek kuthiwe amajoni makabalungise abafundisa idiscipline yokuvuka bahlambe bakwazi ukunxipa ngoba amajoni athi hey get out bathi ha ndiyiqhelanga mna le nto ekhaya mna ndivuki but they have to do it. But we believe we'll bring a new crop of citizens that have actually revised and actually revived their ways of ensuring that they are self-sufficient. Kutoko, unkosikazi wakwaDidiza ningathembi into. She's quite beautiful. Uzobona ningasiphazamisi singalimala ngabantu bakwaDidiza. Eh naba ke bapha kwaMsani kokwabo bangakhathazeka kuba behle lapha nje bayamcenga ubuziphathe kakuhle apho. Here she comes. Sisithokoyiza. Ngizoxoxa ngisuke apho.
Askis, I'm so sorry, Deputy Minister Mekapa. Thank you so much. I've made a mistake. As you can see, as per the program, we were supposed to have another speaker before you, Gepapile, because I saw your beautiful outfit.
Yes,
I wanted to see you.
I wanted to be closer to this lady.
Thank you. Can we give her a warm round of applause, please? Please. Honorable Minister will be coming to you momentarily. I beg your pardon, ladies, gentlemen, friends, colleagues. At this point, I would like to call upon Ms. Sophie Mthombeni from... I've called upon Sophie, forgive me. Wait, it is Sophie. It is Sophie Mthombeni, forgive me. I'd like to call upon Ms. Sophie Mthombeni from Women in Agriculture and Rural Development, Gauteng. Am I wrong? Who are we missing? Hi. From Nafu. Kena Sophie. Askisi. Kekopa Sophie Mthombeni from Nafu. Please, can you join us on the stage? Askisi. Thank you so much. Sorry for the confusion.
Ngumhlonipheki othokothidiza nekhambeli zakhe ningarareki ngilindrebele manje si endrebeleni angikhona ukukhuluma isikhuwa nasengithukiweko amagama la yangirara wesikhuwa manje mhlonipheki netatanyiswa ezikhona zonke ngaphakathi ngiyanihlonipha ojame ngaphambi kwenu nguSophie Mthombeni ngijamele iphiko lenafu njengoba kusichiwo amen manje ngijayele kerekeni ningangirarekeli nenginandre ngisithi amen hallelujah manje ke ngingumfamara ngivela kwaNdrebele ngaphake kuNkangala region ngaphasi komasipalada weThembisile ngingumfamara nje ngizwile umba athi ubhura ngeBonsmara manje mina ngibhura ngeBrahman ngina more than 300 eplasini amaBrahman nokho kwe angingazokukhantsha ngalokho ngizokuthokoza khulu namhlanje ukuthi ke thina ngaphasi kwenafu sifundiswe ukuhlonipha ukuthi sibe bomma abathandanako abomma babambisanako abomma abaphathana kuhle abanganyifulaniko Hallelujah. Manje ngizokuthokoza inro nasima nencane ukuthi sibomake thina ke singapha sisi sinama widow ene ama widow iBhayibheli nalikhulumako lithi uyabona uzimu wathi uthi nekhamba umfazi athule endrodeni aphangakhuluma ni adu uzimu mara umma angakhanjelwa ngibaba uzimu uyasondrela athi mina ngiyindroda yabafelokazi ngingunina wenranran manje sithokoza ukuthandwa kangaka ke kuthi nathi abafelokazi sithandriwe sathandwa nguzimo ene sabe sazokubekwa endaweni emnandi yabona indawo le emnandi mina kenge ngafika endaweni nje kumnandi la cala kunamakho amen manje indaba mnasi ekulukulu indaba miithi sithethe sibomama lapha sithethe khona singaphaswa ekoporasi ikoporasi yethu iphakeme Sebranskraal FPSU ene nasithethe ko lapha sibe bomma sababili sangena enrweni yokuthi siyabambana minister siyathokoza man uyabona ikoporasi yethu leya sinikelwe amatregere 6 amaholland ajameso aqale phasi apaya bhawa kangathathi aw siyathokoza zimo sanikelwa ama harvester angu 4 haleluya ngaphasi kwalombuso esikiwo la haleluya Manje kenge sihlaleke nama harvester la siwabukele nama tracker la siwabukele akaro ngiyiwo sithethe ama tracker la njengabomma sangena emasimini sachinga nemakhweni nasifike emakhweni saba umbereko emakhweni makhuwa sifuna ukunilimela salimela makhuwa makhuwa sibhadela amakhuwa naqedwe kusibhadela Lapha besihlezi khona ekoporasi yethu bekungana telebula bekungana stulo ikhwichi besi ikhwichi lethu belinezinkana engaka uyazibona senzeni minister uyazi sifike sathenga ngemali le esiyenze ematregeren lawa nema harvesten laya sathi asimasukuthwenya umbuso akhe sizenzele nathi umbuso kho ubone ukuthi yini into esingayenza sibafazi umbuso thina sisawuthwenyi sikukuresa kukura nje intrekere zethu sizi hey sizisevisile sithengile ama-office ethu bengana litho sithengile zonke izinto zange officeini ngekwichi nongangena nje na ukazithanda nje iveke zako anginifuna umtshela into yakade ngemali esiyenze ngentrekereza siyokuthenga iveni ngomba amen ngoba siyazi uPaul uthi I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me uzimo sikhonisako sikukhona ukuthi asilethe ngaphansi kwesandla esinje umbuso wethu madidiza siyakuthokoza nasichonje sichu ukuthi ina hayilale amachacha adlule
that was beautiful thank you so much Honorable Minister, before I invite you to the stage, I would like to invite Commissioner Nokuzola Mazibuko from, Nomasonto Mazibuko. How can I forget? Because I met her about 17 years ago when I was still working at SABC. I know her as a pioneer activist. Advocating for people living with albinism long before we saw all these models and actors now on TV she has been pushing for awareness in our communities of people who are living with this condition but tonight she is here in her capacity as a commissioner from the Commission for Gender Equality please can we give her a round of applause
thank you thank you for the opportunity. Because of the influence that my mom Tombe, I'm supposed to say I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. When I entered this morning coming into Eguruleni, my car said you are entering a dangerous area, Babunkosi. and then how dangerous this area became is that I found myself on the stage. Mam titiza, nyabonga, ukuthi nga hijacki, nga hijacki. The opportunity is very important because as I'm speaking here, I'm representing the Commission for Gender Equality, a Chapter 9 institution that says we protect and empower women. And we subpoena all the departments, all the private sector, even SABC program director to say, come and account. How do you treat women? How do you treat youth? How do you treat people with disabilities? But my main message today is to congratulate you, Minister, and your team in Table 1, I was told, and all the ministers who are here, but in particular, Minister Stella, and all the dignitaries that I'm sitting next to in Table 2, from the European Union, from our representatives, now even now Umamut Thomas, to say, hey, South Africa, you are not aware that the Gender Commission is not running only for GPV. The spirit in this room from the morning was saying, we are protected. We are united. We are going to be one. Power to the people. Power to the women. Power to the leadership. Mom Stella, you said, niyakwazi mos ukuthi niyoqoqa izimali zenu Mam Thombeni, because we were misled that the only thing you should do, you must save to bury each other. We saved, my brother, we saved to get proper caskets. But today, we were told by our ministers to say, unite. There's no pull-down syndrome. We are going to unite and give the food and get all the meat. I'm sitting next to my friend in my table who is vegan, doesn't want to have anything with warawara. But be it that you are a vegan, you need the soil for the vegetables, and the women are here. Ladies and gentlemen, as I conclude, those of you who didn't go to the other room where people were exhibiting, the exhibition gave us, Minister, the exhibition gave us to say, this program, the symposium, put together the generation gap. We speak about equality in the Gender Commission, but we saw the Deputy Minister here and the young woman who told us, who is going to provide food for tomorrow when you don't empower me as a young person? Take us along. Minister, Agriculture, Small Business, Mam Stella. This is a very important day where we took a resolution that this is an annual event. This is where we're going to measure ourselves from today. Come October next year, we will be saying, we are united in power because we have worked together. Haya tumama kosigazi. Haya tumama kosigazi. Haya tumama kosigazi. Haya ngene pala. Tuma tuma. Tuma tuma. Oh.
What a befitting way to introduce our host for this evening, Honorable Minister Metoko Didiza.
Ayatumama kosigazi. Ayongene parliament. Thank you very much, ma'am. Wow. This is an exciting evening, a culmination of what we did the whole day. I want to stand on the protocols that have already been established so that we do not waste time. I also don't want to stand between you and the awards that you are going to receive and dinner and the dance floor. Some of my colleagues seated there with me were saying they would like the balloon to come back so that they can dance on the balloon themselves. I'd like to acknowledge our Excellency, the Ambassador of the European Union, who's also here with us, the FAO representative, who's also here, my colleague, the Deputy Minister, as well as the MECs of Agriculture present here. I must say that the departments that we're having, maybe earlier on we only mentioned the departments that were presenting, such as DTIC and small business. We do have here the Department of Basic Education. Other people may wonder, why basic education? Skills development, in our view, is a very important one, particularly in agriculture. We need to change the mentality of what some of you and my generation experienced, that your relationship with agriculture was when you had done wrong in class and you were punished and therefore you had to go to the garden. Today we want to encourage our young people to know that agriculture is a career which they can choose in order to develop themselves and their communities. And we want to start that at a very early level with basic education. One of the advantages that basic education has is the school grounds. It's not only the sporting facilities that you find in the schools, but there's enough space which children can use partly for demonstration as part of their learning experiences when they deal with sciences. So that when they read the theory about germination of plants, they can actually go and practice on the soil. So part of our responsibility is agriculture. It's how do we partner with Department of Education, because they are not in the business of farming, but as part of skills development, they actually give the theoretical understanding on the sector. So ours is to give them implements and tools so that ngeza, kiriva, and your rakes and your spades, they can actually have the tools so that they can work those gardens with our young people. But also, agriculture being a science, it's also an economic sector. As we've heard from Abo Mampinki saying, they are queen of Bonsmaras. You see, a queen of Bonsmara and a queen of Brahman means you are at the level that, you know, the mula comes in. We're moving away from a stage that, you know, you like to see your cow and say, Nguchamlut. You know, once a person starts naming the cow, aike, the economic dimension of it is sipelile, because you develop a sentiment. But we want people who are going to say, 8 months, I can fetch the best price in the market from this calf. We want somebody like Mom Anna who would say, these pigs, because of the way in which they multiply, I can actually feed Pick and Pay every day. Today we're here not only to learn, as we did in the morning through the symposium, but also to recognize excellence. Part of that recognition award that we are doing is to say, here are women against all odds who who have made it in the sector. Through them, as a mirror for me, I can look at them and say, I can do it. So it's not about the competition. It's actually about recognition. Because there may be three, but they represent all of us. And would like to say thank you to the European Union, our competitors, for allowing that partnership tonight. But tomorrow, we will fight about the rules. That's what competition is all about. We are friends, but we can also have, you know, bitter fights in order to succeed. Just to tell you a little story, picking up on the EU, I was in Parliament and as a member of the Commonwealth Women's chapter. So we had to participate in a conference in London, and we took a cab, you know, like an Uber, to go to where the venue was. And because there were heads of state and all these MPs from all the member states that are part of the Commonwealth, our driver was a bit irritated. So I said, sir, what's the problem? He says, you know, I don't know, it's too full in London, and I'm not used to this thing. Traffic, you know, with that accent. I said, don't worry. We're actually here as members of your former colonies, who were once your children, as protectorate, to see Auntie Queen. I could see the gentleman frowning. I said, don't worry. You'll just have these irritations when cousins come once in a lifetime to just see Auntie and yourselves as cousins. So don't worry, I'm not rushing. Just be steady, we will get there. At the end, the fellow just laughed. What I was trying to say is that part of the legacy of colonialism and apartheid created other bonds between us. Not just that we're part of the global community, but also that painful relationship made us to become trading partners of the future. So today, I think our European Union appreciates that, yeah, it's important to support these women. And I will take him further after this meeting, after this dinner, that you saw that there are women who are in the agricultural space that are succeeding. So let's have a conversation on market access. So that these women can find their, you know, products at CNA in Germany, in Brussels, where the EU is. One advantage which I'm sure Jan van Riebeek saw when he came to our shores is that we've got the sun that ripens our fruits the best the world over. So we can't compete on oranges with Spain, I mean, really. They may produce the oranges, but they're not as sweet as ours. But somewhere we must give and take. So some of those challenges, I think you will, as partly South African, since you are here, you'll be able to say to your guys in the EU, chaps, I live there, I know these fruits are mwah. And from a quality point of view, you can't doubt. But today, it's about recognition. I want to say to the women who will be recognized tonight, we appreciate the work that you have put in your enterprises. We want to congratulate you for the hard work, for the passion, as well as the determination. Because if you are in this sector, you must be a person of stronger faith. You know, when Uma Umthombeni was saying ufunde ekerekeni and kept on saying hallelujah, amen. Even if you don't go to church, when the turf gets going and the rain comes in, you know, more than what you expect, and the heat wave of Gauteng gives you a run for your money if you have already planted, there is no way you can say, "Aike, uthixo ubukhonuthini." We don't have a NASDAQ in agriculture, you know, where people can look at the news and say, what's happening in the East, and da, da, da. Yours is a God-given NASDAQ every day. And that is why, if you have to survive in the sector like these women were recognizing, you must be strong, you must be resilient. I liked Ume Anna and said, I looked at that letter and I said, Ndizayo beka pa, if Lamlungu was able to use this water, why not me? And that's the resilience. Ukumele chiki nje kancinci. You just arrive at that spa with that confidence. You know, when your gumboots, even if you still have your overalls, your gumboot is there, you can actually say to the manager of Pick and Pay, thank you, sir. I'm sorry, and so I actually produce cabbages better than what you have. Can I give you a price? Here's my sample. You know, let me tell you, the reaction will be shocked because he's not expecting that. That's what you can do. But also trusting your confidence, he will say, okay, let me see your quality. You've got the foot on the door. And this is what these women who are recognizing today are showing us, that it is possible against all odds. So for me tonight is to say, congratulations. You are our trailblazers, joining many other women, because some of them today we may not recognize, but they've been there and they've succeeded, like Mamu Upinki, Mam Tombedi, Mam Anna, Sis Zandile, and many others who spoke to us today, who show us that it is possible. And I'd like, as I recognize those women, to thank my colleagues, the MEC, because at times when you sit in your office, you never wonder, you actually wonder whether what I do in this department, does it make a difference? So when we see you tonight from these different provinces, I'm sure my MECs are saying, hey, akulahlwa mbile kungakufelo. Ikhona lento endiyenzayo. So it means there's a difference. Oh, I forgot. Akulahlwa mbile kungakufelo. What it literally means, if I were to give the literal, you know, explanation. It doesn't mean that when you have lost a child, because in Mbeleko we use it to put our children on the back when they are young. It doesn't mean when you lose a child, you may not get the other one. So you don't throw that away. You keep it, trusting God that you'll have a child another time. So my MECs today will be saying the same. My Deputy Minister, Gina, of Trade and Industry and Competition, who's joined us tonight, will be saying the same, because when she goes and look for market access, she sometimes wonder whether what I do make a difference for these women in the agricultural sector. So as we celebrate with you today, it's not only us who put it from the input side, it's her who takes it to the processing side and into the market. That is why she, as well as Mr. Landabeni, are here, because all of us, what we do is to make you succeed. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Honorable Minister. Thank you. And now we've arrived at the moment that we have all been waiting for, where we acknowledge the recipients of our recognition awards, starting with the smallholder farmers. So how this will roll out? First, there'll be a video of our recipients for the smallholder Farmer Awards, Recognition Awards. And as the video is playing, I would like to ask you, Kahlompho, dear ladies, please will you line up here? And we will ask our colleagues from the department to assist us in making sure, Hori, you line up in order of the video as it plays. And then after that, we will invite our dignitaries to come to the stage. I'll call upon them to help us hand over the awards. You will receive the awards one by one, but please don't sit down again. Please line up once again, because at the end, once everyone has received the award in that category, then we're going to take a group photo. Make sense? Okay, okay, thank you so much. Presenting the Smallholder Awards, or the Smallholder Recognition Awards, will be, I would like to invite the Honorable Minister back to the stage. I would like to invite the Deputy Minister for Department of Trade, Industry and Competition, Deputy Minister Gona. And I'd like to invite the Deputy Minister of Agriculture, Gina, askisi, Gina, sorry, baitse Gona, sorry, Gina, askisi, tswarelo. Deputy Minister Gina, and then I would like to invite the Deputy Minister of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development back to the stage, Deputy Minister Kapa, who to present the first category. So please, let us meet the first category of farmers who we will be celebrating tonight, our smallholder farmers.
Togozile Vivian Boboi from the Eastern Cape is the owner of Sonop Business Enterprise Private Limited, located in Melton Gardens, Queenstown. Sonop Farm is an agribusiness entity which focuses on vegetable tunnel production, branding, marketing and distribution of farm produce to wholesalers and retailers in the Queenstown CBD. They supply local retailers within Komani and have an offtake agreement with Mabovula retailers. The enterprise is SA GAP accredited. The pre-processed vegetable brand will be launched in the local markets with an ambition to export. Disebo Makadza Soga from the Free State is the owner of DY Trading. The farm is located between Kroonstad and Odendalsrus in the Lutshwelebutswa district. In 2014, through the PLAS program, she acquired the 386-hectare farm, comprising of 210 hectares of grazing pasture and 170 hectares of arable land. DY Dairy has 50 Ayrshire dairy cows, which are milked daily, and each cow produces an average of 18 litres per day. The milk is supplied to Clover, who collect every second day. Disebo rears over 50 calves and then markets them at auctions when they are under 5 months old. She also supplies wiener bulls. She has employed 4 permanent and 6 seasonal workers. From Gauteng is Susan Ponto Van Beng, the sole owner of Beyond 360 Supply and Projects, registered in 2011. In February 2014, Van Beng Investments bought 25 hectares of land at Pardefontein and erected farm infrastructure such as a borehole, staff quarters, 160,000 litre reservoir, drip irrigation system, and shade netting. Then in 2015, they started with production of baby marrows, patty pans, a variety of herbs, gooseberries, beetroot, spinach, kale, cauliflower, and green beans. The Department of Rural Development and Land Reform assisted with the farm assessment. Beyond 360 supplies produce to Spa Moraletta, Spa Sable Hill, Food Lovers, and other major retailers. They employ 4 permanent and 15 seasonal employees. Iqiniso Lini Zulu of Iqiniso Primary Cooperative, located in Ngqothu, KwaZulu Natal, started farming with 8 goats in 2010. And to date, her herd has grown to about 162 goats and 170 cattle. She uses communal land for grazing and buys animal supplements such as hay bales, commercial feed, hominy chop and maize for weight gain. Iqiniso maintains a significantly low mortality by treating sick animals herself and adheres to well-planned vaccination schedules. Her market is mainly within the province and stretches across the country. When demand is higher than her supply, due to the number of traditional ceremonies her animals are used for, she buys from other farmers to supply. She donates the goats to poor families to use for rituals during difficult times. She employs 4 people to herd the livestock and has also been allocated 2 graduates as part of the graduate placement program by the Department of Agriculture. From the Eastern Cape is Patricia Peta, who is a member of Bafazi Pambili, a cooperative owned by 6 female beneficiaries. The project is situated in Jansenville in the Dr. Beyers Noordeur local municipality. They are currently operating on a 2-hectare farm and are farming with broiler chickens at a capacity of 1,500 chicks on a temporary structure granted by the Department of Rural Development and Agrarian Reform. Due to their commitment to the business, the department has assisted with another structure with a carrying capacity of 3,200 chicks and a cool room. From Limpopo is Sarah Podo, the owner of Murumo Poultry. This farm is located in Waterberg District in Bela Bela and measures 21 hectares. The primary focus of the farm is egg and broiler production and supplies to clients around Gauteng, Limpopo and nearby provinces. They have identified the egg and poultry demand for processing factories such as retailers, bakeries, hotels, restaurants and hospitals. The farm boasts 3 production houses with a capacity of 22,000 in total, 2 rearing houses, and the others house 6,000 and 3,000 capacity, respectively. Moromo currently supplies resellers and the informal markets in Bela Bela, and formerly to Joseame wholesalers. She employs 4 permanent workers and hosts 2 graduates. From Mpumalanga is Piwe Nduli, the owner of Marumo Brahman Farming, located in Virina. She started farming at an early age and holds an MSc in International Rural Development from the Royal Agricultural University in the UK. Obtained in 2011, the farm extends 1,170 hectares with the livestock of 50 cows and 2 bulls on 11 hectares of planted pasture, which yields over 300 bales, as well as 3 hectares of dry land maize production. The cattle are sold at local auctions, resold to commercial farmers, as well as to feedlots in and around the Nkangala region. The farmer employs 1 permanent and 5 seasonal workers. Kiribonye Ellen Kaweng is the owner of Kubukwena Farming, located in Barkley West in the Northern Cape. It is a plus farm purchased by the Department of Land Reform and Rural Development in 2019. In 2015, she started off with just 10 goats and 10 sheep. Over the years, she built up her livestock by selling male animals and buying female animals. She is currently rearing 90 cattle, 70 sheep and 260 goats, and has also planted 10 hectares of lucerne and will be planting 3 hectares of watermelon and pumpkin in spring. She markets her products locally to informal markets and to formal markets like GWK and Vleis Central in Kimberley. The farm currently employs 6 permanent workers. From the Northwest is Anna Mavula, who is the owner of Mavula Enterprise, located in Brits. After the passing of her husband, who bought her first farm, she has grown the enterprise to produce an impressive 80 tons of different vegetables throughout the year. The production from the farm is delivered to two stores around Tabazimbi, Pick n Pay, and some are sold directly to consumers and hawkers. The project has managed to buy a tractor, disc harrow, boom sprayer, and a ripper through their savings. Miss Mavula has employed two permanent employees, 14, that is 6 men and 8 women seasonally. The Western Cape's Charlene Boddenham is the owner of Cowter's Broiler Chicken Farm, situated in Hopefield. The project started in 2015, producing 1,500 bird broilers per cycle, and have a bulk market that takes 1,000 birds, and the remainder is sold to the private markets. They have two chicken houses, which host 2,500 chickens each, with storage facilities for feed and cleaning equipment. She employs one permanent and two temporary workers.
I'd like to call upon Honorable Minister Didiza, Deputy Minister Gina, and Deputy Minister Kapa to join me on stage to present these incredible women with their recognition awards. Can we give them a round of applause, please? Such inspiring stories to hear. We appreciate you, we are thankful for you, and we know that behind each of you is the many people who you represent, the many people who you employ, the many communities that are touched by the work that you do. Thank you so much.
Ngifuna ukuhlala nginawe.
Thank you to Honorable Minister, Honorable Deputy Ministers. We appreciate you and congratulations once again. Congrats once again. Which brings us to our next category, which is smallholders. Ladies, gentlemen, friends, and colleagues, let us meet the 9 incredible women who we will be recognizing this evening. I beg your pardon. The next category is commercial farmers. Let's meet the commercial farmers, ladies and gentlemen. The last category was smallholders.
From the Free State, Nono Moipone Mohabe is the manager of Zinfonex Trading Pty Limited, trading as NEM. In Senegal. In 16, the farmer owned funds to construct 2 pig grower houses, which accommodate 320 pigs each. She supplies giants such as Dreamland Abattoir in Funderbale Park and Swiss Valley in Harry Smith, as well as the informal market. She employs 4 permanent and 2 seasonal workers. Mampe Merehi from Gauteng is the project manager of Demareta Piggery Project. Located in Langzi Kurgat in the Lesedi local municipality, the project sits on a 214-hectare plot, wherein 60 hectare is planted with pasture, 115 with grain, and 2 hectares of vegetable production. The farm was acquired through the PLAS program. Currently, the project has 210 breeding sows, 3 boars, 600 weaners, 350 porkers, 300 baconers, 300 piglets, 45 sheep and 5 cattle, supplying both formal and informal markets. The project employs 14 workers, 9 permanent and 5 workers on a temporary basis. Letsiwe Mthethwa from KZN is the director of Wise Kingdom Pty Limited, located on 621 hectare of land in Crane Valley Farm in Dannhauser. The entity specializes in beef, pork, mutton or lamb cutting and processing meat such as mince, vorse, sausages, Russians, bacon, smoked ribs, leg and shank. The livestock is slaughtered at abattoirs in Newcastle and Glencoe. The carcasses are then picked up from the abattoirs to the farm for processing. Currently, the entity still operates as small scale due to industry standards. This business also boasts a lucrative crop production wing supplying maize and soya to AFGRI silos. The entity markets itself to surrounding communities in the province. She supplies stock to auctions, local hospitals, clinics and schools. Wise Kingdom employs 4 seasonal and 3 permanent workers, all youth with 1 male. Tepiso Isabel Mameja from Limpopo is the owner of Maswele Farming Pty Limited, located in Lofstal, Trichastal. The farm was acquired through the PLAS program of the Department of Agriculture and Land Reform in 2015. The farm spans 7 hectares and are used for production of agricultural commodities, mangoes, a variety of vegetables, agronomic crops, as well as beef cattle production. A mango orchard on the farm occupies 80 hectares and 160 hectares is used for vegetable production and agronomic crops. The remaining 127 hectares is used for extensive grazing of livestock. The produce is marketed to local retailers and hawkers within the surrounding towns and villages of Tzaneen, as well as Spa and the Pretoria and Johannesburg fresh produce markets. The livestock is marketed at local auction houses on a weekly basis. Mpumalanga is Esther Nunu Mhlongo, the owner of Ajuri Farms, located outside Barberton. She acquired the farm through a lease agreement in 2013 and produces vegetables, macadamia nuts, avocados, and rears tortoises, poultry, rabbits, and pigs. She also does aquaculture, cultivates lawn grass, and agro processing. On 100 hectares, she grows macadamia, which is in full production, and 15 hectares of newly grown plants, and another 5 of macadamia nursery. There is 5 hectares of avocado in full production, and 2 hectares planted with lawn grass. Esther produces 7 types of the most popular commercial macadamia trees and supplies processed macadamia nuts to a company known as Nuts Pro to international markets. She employs 36 permanent and 78 seasonal workers. Esther Margarita Fisser from the Northern Cape is the owner of Lakshmi Boerdery Pty Limited, which is situated 2 hours west of Kuruman. The farm spans 6,000 hectares, which is divided into 10 camps of 600 hectares each. She started with 120 Simbra cattle and currently has 350 herd of cattle. She trained her permanent employees to maintain the camps and water infrastructure so that they can sustain the natural resources such as land and water. She provides her livestock with feed supplements to help protect the land from overgrazing. Esther employs 4 workers. Hailing from the Northwest is Louisa Maluka Mohotsi, the owner of Healthy Life for Achievers in Rustenburg. The farm Ellenskraal is leased from the Department of Rural Development and Land Reform and is situated in Mooi Nooi, Madibeng local municipality. The farm's primary focus is citrus and it produces 1,000 tons of oranges per season. She has planted 10 hectares of lemons with the aim of exporting. Locally, she markets her harvest to Magalie's Citrus Co-op and some to Surjuice in Pretoria. The farm employs 4 permanent and 20 casual employees during harvest season. From the Western Cape is Alfreda Stephanie Mars, the sole owner of Triple M Boerdery Pty Limited, located in Morrisburg. The farm was acquired in 2014 through PLAS, and the main enterprise on the farm is sheep and grain production. The farm spans 266 hectares, which is divided into 36.6 hectares for natural grazing veld and 200 hectares of dry land, predominantly used for winter grains. The farmer also rears sheep flock, made up of 120 Don Merino ewes, 45 cattle, and grows wheat, oats, and lupins. The farm spans 266 hectares, which is divided into 36.6 hectares for natural grazing veld and 200 hectares of dry land, predominantly used for winter grains. She markets her grain through and a sheep and cattle to Ander Kallis and CW for wool. She employs 5 permanent and 4 seasonal workers.
A warm round of applause for our excellent farmers in the commercial category. I would like to invite MEC for Northern Cape, Ms. Manopole, MEC for Northwest, Ms. Mohono, and MEC for Mpumalanga, Ms. Sheba, please to join us in presenting the recognition awards to our fantastic recipients. Thank you so much. done. We are left with one more very important category now. We will be honoring our 9 agro processors. Let us meet these extraordinary women.
Lilita Mahlatsi is the owner of Ivili Loboya Wool Processing Hub in Butterworth in the Eastern Cape. Lo is involved in the entire agro-processing value chain, supplying both domestic and international markets. Their products include cashmere, wool apparel, deco fabrics, scoured white wool, black and brown wool for insoles, chlorinated high-quality wool, and thermal insulation. To date, depending on the fiber, Ivili Loboya harvests raw fiber and processes fiberglass, scour, dehair, blend, card, comb, and mill spin. They also develop products such as hand spin, dye, knit, and weave. Chantel Debrain from the Free State is the owner of Buttercup Farmhouse, located in Bloemfontein. The entity is an organic food and beverage consumer outlet currently specializing in processing organic vegetable coffee made from butternut as well as soy. Butternut is the main ingredient in all beverages and sauces. Buttercup Farmhouse Organic Ground Vegetable Coffee is known for its added nutrients and vitamins. The beverage can be served either hot or cold or as an organic smoothie. Buttercup Farmhouse supplies to wellness stores locally and to international markets. She employs 2 permanent and 11 seasonal workers. From Gauteng, Duduetsang Seletse is the co-owner of Sheer Glory, a company established in 2016. The company is located in Marola View, Mabopane. Sheer Glory was started by cousins Duduetsang and Ureneile out of passion and a need for natural products. The founders are passionate about economic development and upliftment of women, especially in business. The company manufactures 6 skin and hair care products, such as marula oil, facial cleanser, facial cream, hair butter, beard oil and skin butter. The company uses social media to market their products and exhibit at flea markets, farmers markets, and other social events. They employ seasonal workers. Nogwanda Mkunu from Kwamaphumulo of the eco-friendly business Pink Prince Farm Produce, which was established in 2018, holds a national diploma from Sedara College of Agriculture. The entity started operating out of a home garage and produces processed meat. She usually produces 1,000 kilograms of meat product per month. She employs 3 young people. Her market is the local community and she also services the province. Pink Print is certified by local environmental health and the growth plan is to acquire an ISO 22000 accredited processing plant to meet the standards of the clients they have offtake agreements with. Unfortunately, the business was hard hit by the recent floods. From Limpopo is Dumelo Faith Manya, who is the sole owner and general manager of Soldado Tea. She performs the business managerial functions such as production, marketing and financial management. The company was established in 2015 and is located in Senwabarwana Township, Bochum. The business pickles different vegetables and also supplies fresh cut vegetables such as spinach, butternut, cabbage, carrots, beetroots, and tomato cherry sauces. Produce is mainly sold to local households, fresh produce markets in Bloburg, Polokwane, and nearby shopping complex stores. She employs workers on a temporary basis. Mpumalanga's Meister van Wyk is the owner of Rolmay Goat and Sheep Dairy, located in Goedehoop in Bethal area. Her farm was purchased in 2000 and measures 258 hectares in total, with 5 hectares being utilized for the dairy production and the other parts are used for natural grazing for cattle and extensive sheep production. The products produced on the farm include drinking milk, cheeses such as Camembert, Gouda, mixed milk cheddar, Brevi Lunis, and Greek-style yogurt. The products are bottled, labeled, packed, and distributed to different markets. She supplies the local spa in Mpumalanga and Gauteng markets. Rolmay Farm has come up with new varieties of cheese, namely Italian, French, Spanish, and American cheddar. Tandi Wright is representing her mother, Anna Madibuseng Wright, from the Northern Cape. Since 2015, she harvested various vegetables on a 5-hectare plot in Richey. Miss Wright graduated from subsistence to smallholder farmer. They market their products to local informal markets and supply formal markets such as Kimberley Fresh Produce Market and shops around Kimberley, Jacobsdal and Richey, and the Johannesburg Fresh Produce Market. The agro-processing wing of the business uses part of the harvest to make and sauces, which they package and supply to local businesses. From the surrounding townships, they employ 4 permanent employees and 4 temporary in season. Nomathemba Langa is from the Northwest. She is the owner of agricultural enterprise Inyama Yetu, focusing on livestock production and processing. Her enterprise's agro-processing division makes salami, cheese grillers, vorse, viennas, biltong, and offers meat hampers. Her products are distributed to wholesalers and retails to the public at her butchery, as well as direct deliveries to households. Her livestock and game are taken to abattoirs for slaughtering and are brought back to the butchery for processing. She also sells and delivers whole carcasses within range. The enterprise supplies porkers and baconers to the formal market. She employs 4 permanent and 3 temporary workers. From the Western Cape is Daphne Liesel Niethling, who is the owner of Paardenkloof Estate, which sits on 1,430 hectares in the heart of the Cape Floral Kingdom. She preserves about 1,000 hectares for its pristine mountainous fynbos, which includes rare red date species and critically endangered Rennisterveld. The farm spans a total of 400 hectares, divided into 24 hectares for perennial crops, 17 hectares for irrigated pastures, 100 hectares for dry land, and 1,100 hectares for natural grazing. She specializes in sheep and beef rearing, as well as vineyard and protea production. She has established 23 hectares of remote mountainous vineyards on the border of the Babylon Storing Nature Reserve, where she produces premium matured Shiraz, Cabernet Sauvignon, Pinot Noir, and Sauvignon Blanc wines. She supplies to KWV, Woolworths, Villierstorp Cellars, Newton Johnson, Lorna, CMW, and Groenland Abattoir. Paardenkloof Estate has employed 9 permanent and 40 seasonal workers.
You can do better than that. A bigger round of applause for our winners, friends and colleagues. So did you notice we moved from small farmers to larger scale commercial farmers and now to processing? Did you notice that the majority of the women in this category are youth? And they're not just involved in primary production, but secondary and tertiary production, which is so exciting. And it dispels the myth that young people in this country are not interested in farming, because look, Congratulations. Congratulations. To present these awards, I would like to call on MEC Peters from the Eastern Cape. Please, would you join me on stage? I'd like to call on DG Ramasodi. Please, would you join me on stage? And I would like to call on Dr. Chikoko from Food and Agriculture Organization. Please, would you join us to present these wonderful women with their awards? Thank you so much. Another round of applause for our winners in Agro Processing. Well done. And we are nearly at the very end of our formal program. But before we eat and dance and drink and groove and enjoy, I can see the spirit of groove is alive and well in you. And it's understandable. You need to dance. You deserve to dance. But before we dance, I would like to call upon one of our sponsors who the minister also acknowledged. Please can we welcome from the Ecosystem Development for Small Enterprise, Mr. Theodorus Kaspers, who is the first counselor, head of cooperation, to give us our vote of thanks for this evening. You are the vegan. Are you the vegan? No, you're not the vegan. I thought it was you. Askis. It's not vote of thanks. Oh, I apologize. I apologize. I keep jumping this evening. I'm so sorry. I'm so very sorry. Message of support from our sponsor. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Honorable ministers, deputy ministers, fellow speakers, and in particular, women agro entrepreneurs and farmers, it was amazing what we have seen this morning. Ambassador Sandra Kramer asked me to represent her. She would have loved to be here among fellow women and actually officiate this. But she asked me, head of cooperation of the European Union delegation, to go instead of her. The only female credentials I can boast is that I'm married and I have 5 daughters. And just to be very clear, in my culture, the father of the bride pays for the wedding. So no, I'm not very rich. Still, I'm very conscious of the fact that I'm standing between you and the main meal. So I've been feverishly trying to cut my speech shorter and shorter. But still, I would like to say a few things. First of all, like previous speaker, I would like to re-emphasize that agriculture and related activities along the value chain, like agro-processing and clean technology, are key to transform developing economies. A topic that gets more and more attention is the role of women in this transformative agenda. Looking at historical differences in societies in terms of access to means of production, access to finance, and access to markets. And I'm indeed particularly pleased that young women are taking up agro-processing. My second observation is that South Africa and the EU, despite our differences, honorable ministers, are like-minded on many issues, in particular on gender equality and social inclusion. And I was very pleased with the comments of Mayor Commissioner on how important indeed gender equality is. And we're putting, as EU, a lot of emphasis in that. EU, not only the EU delegation, but also our member states in a broader Team Europe approach and continue to work on this critical issue. One of our partners in South Africa is the Department of Women, Youth and Persons with Disabilities. And we're financing gender and women economic empowerment program. This program supports the South African government's efforts to allocate resources on gender empowerment and gender budgeting. I trust, Honorable Minister, that that's happening in your ministry as well. And improving gender mainstreaming across departments. And I'm confident that this will address the issue of women in agriculture and the benefit of the department. Farmers, agribusinesses, retailers, consumers are all key players in food and nutrition security, health, environmental sustainability, and rural livelihoods. Let me point out that our food systems between Europe and South Africa are interconnected. And I don't know if you're aware, Honorable Minister, but there is still a positive trade balance in favor of South Africa of 15 billion rand of agri-food products going to the EU. And the growth in 2020 of South Africa's agricultural exports to the EU was almost double that than to the rest of the world. And this means business for all farmers, including women farmers. Looking ahead, with nine out of 10 European consumers ready to pay a fair price for healthy and tasty food, your products from rooibos to wine are well positioned in the European market. I know, therefore, how important it is to make the most of our strong trade relations. Statistics show that women who control about 5% of South Africa's land provide 80% of the agricultural labor. Also, about 70% of smallholders in South Africa are women. We see the transformation of the food systems as a major opportunity to accelerate our contribution to the Sustainable Development Goals. Our commitment to women in agriculture is already being translated into the current cooperation with South Africa. And I will just highlight, I had many examples, but like I said, I want to be short, so I just want to take out two. Because I know as well that the Minister of SMME has been a very active participant today. Small businesses, especially women-owned businesses, experience several challenges in seeking access to markets, and one of these is compliance with food safety requirements. We are working to improve SMME compliance with food safety and quality requirements, particularly in value chains that have a high potential for growth and job creation. So in a way, Minister, we are shooting ourselves in the foot by trying to help you on some of our standards. Secondly, the EU, through the EDSE program, which we are sponsoring this event with, has also provided support to the She Trades South Africa platform, which supports women-owned enterprises, both of farmers and agro-processors, to enter trade markets. Thank you again for giving me an opportunity to participate in this important ceremony. It was a delight of witnessing a lineup of successful women in agriculture, and they are at the core of the transformation agenda in the country. Thank you.
Thank you. Those are profound statistics. Women control 5% of the land but provide 80% of the labor. Wow. That means there's a lot of transformation that needs to take place in our lifetime. Thank you to the representative from the EU. At this point, I would like to invite the DG of the department, Mr. Moketsa Ramasodi, to deliver our vote of thanks. Thank you.
Good evening. Normally, when you stand before people who are having a tussle in their brains between themselves and food security, you have got to be very quick. Let me greet you all in this sector that has got the most beautiful women in South Africa. Because this sector is responsible for food security, and there's none who goes to bed without eating. All of you are involved in that. Some of you, I'm told that one third of us come from rural areas. I was raised in a rural area, and you come from there, the most beautiful women. And all of you walk on land and stay on land. And therefore, you are in the right department. Let me rise on the protocols that have been set before me, but let me also thank both ministers who are here today. Minister Stella Ndabeni Abraham, and our minister, Minister Toko Didiza, for steering this ship and ensuring that women in agriculture and agro-processing are really represented. Allow me to indicate that I attended the Wekona engagements, and the country representative from the UN Women said something very profound. She said, South Africa is committed toward women empowerment. And she has been in many countries, and I think that is very good recognition for our country. We'd also like to thank the deputy ministers who are here, Deputy Minister Tapa and Deputy Minister Gina. I always like listening to Deputy Minister Tapa, and I'm saying one day I will have a rendition about her as an individual. DM Gina, thank you very much. The DTIC and the Department of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development are in partnership. We are inseparable. We have become stuck at the hip, and we are going to move these women engagements forward. I would like to thank the MECs that are here, and I would like them to rise in unison, because these are the people, these are the women in our sector that makes this sector to tick. MECs, you are highly appreciated. Thank you very much. I would like to move to the partners that we have in the international arena, starting with the FAO. We thank you very much. Going through to AU AUDA, there's been a lot of work that we have done, and the contributions that we have made today are really appreciated. I'd also like to appreciate the EU for the sponsorship, although there are a few things, Minister, that I would like to discuss with them, but this is not the night. This is the night to celebrate the women. I'd also like to thank all the participants from the side of our agriculture organization, NAFU. We have got AFASA. We have got all women organizations, including WAD. Thank you very much for coming through. I would like to thank all the participants who are here, from the smallholders going through to commercial and also to our agro processing in our country. I visited each and every stall, and I must say I enjoyed all of you. Behind each and every successful program, there are those people who are even praying, when is this night over? I would like to thank everybody from all the departments who were responsible for organizing this event, because it takes a village to just organize this event. Thank you very much, colleagues. You did quite well. I would also like to thank everybody who came in here, and most of all the men who are supporting the women. Because the fight that the women are having are not against men, but it's against patriarchy. And patriarchy is not males. Patriarchy is a behavior that is infested in some of the men. And therefore, we thank you for being here, for being supportive. And I would then like to end up by thanking the program director for the day. Auslebo, you continue to amaze me. Reagolebo. To all the participants, the night has been memorable. For me, it has been something that I will indelibly mark in my own calendar and will never be erased from the annals of the history of this department. Thank you very much, Rea Leboh.
Thank you so much, DJ Ramasodi. It's been my pleasure to be of service to all of you this evening. Before we open up the buffet and the dance floor, I'd like to invite the women from the Lindingonelo Quintet to please set up. They'll be entertaining you this evening. An all-women quartet, all-women band is going to be entertaining you tonight. And then before I invite everyone to go and eat, because you've been waiting so patiently, and I know the program started late, you've been an incredible audience. Thank you very much. I would like to invite our esteemed winners to please come back to the stage for a group photo with the Honorable Minister. And then we will open up the floor for food and enjoyment. Please, may I ask you, all of you, to make your way to the stage. We're going to take a group photo. We're going to celebrate you and clap for you and dance for you and sing for you and take your pictures. Your celebrity moment is not done. We still want to see you and enjoy you. Yes. Okay. For the last time, we want to see you in all of your glory. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Can we get closer? Can we move? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Please, can we fill in the spaces? Thank you. Thank you. We need some more space.
Oh, gorgeous. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done.
And also friends, colleagues, families, supporters who want to take this group photo, use the opportunity now. Let's hear the phone call fail. Mpagathi batla dance floor. We've heard you, we recognize you.
Wakuri shakamo ima.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
cry, they smile and they dance. Celebrating life with you, but not without a cry. Celebrating life with you, not without a smile. Celebrating life with you, but not without a dance. Celebrating life with you, with everything it brings. Oh, fly away my heart, don't despair. The world is full of joy. You cry, you smile, and you dance. Fly away, love, sound, and wisdom I can't see. People of the world, they cry, they smile, and they dance.
ain't squeaky cliche. Sometimes you got a little sleep on the street. You ain't no saint, we all a sinner. Wants to put your good foot down and make your soul the weather. I respect when you're so fat and you're all that. Plus you're free, then you're humble, man, and I'm your feeling. I can feel everything that you breathe. Let's take a long run around the park after dark. Find a spot for us to spot conversations, verbal elation, stimulation. Share our situations, temptations, education, relaxation, elevation. Or maybe we could talk about Revelations 3:17. Or maybe we could see a movie. Or maybe we could see a play on Saturday. Or maybe we could roll a tree and feel the breeze and listen to a symphony. Or maybe chilling just Lee. Or maybe, maybe we could take a cruise or eat some passion food. Or maybe eat some passion food. Or maybe cry to the blues. Or maybe we should just keep silent. Come on, let's take a long walk around the park.
very much. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Angza? Angza? Thank you very much. Please show some love to Lindy Ngonelo on piano, Katie Ware on drums, Al Stebza on bass, Sintu on saxophone. My name is Titi Luzipo and we're the Lindy Ngonelo Quintet. Thank you.